And they also had a temple unit attached to their hermitage. A temple is required for the mystery activities conducted. What are the mystery activities? What do we mean by mysteries? In many places in the books of Alice A. Bailey, we find the terms the mystery temples of the ancients. And we find the statement that once again the mystery temples will be opened. What do we mean by it? Let us try to express our individual thoughts about this term also now. Because it is the seventh ray activity. We try to approach what is intelligence and what is knowledge. For the present, we came to understand from all the statements gathered that intelligence is a potentiality which can be compared with a cassette like this. And knowledge is the passage that is recorded. Change the cassette. No, she should change her cassette. Now, let us try to approach the seventh ray activity. We want to know mysterious and mystery temple. Two terms used not less than about 600 times in all the volumes of Alice A. Bailey. Madam, we need not count, because before I know, you must be knowing that there exists a grand index to all these works. So we can conveniently count in the index. So let us once again count and verify afterwards, but let us try to understand what a mystery is now. Let us all try to express our own ideas about it. About ourselves? Yeah. Inner? I think thoughts are always inner. Pardon? Hidden from or hidden to? Certain? In a most mystic and Freemasonry language. Establishing new? What's the use of establishing more number of temples when already there?
No.
Re-establishing the existing temples? It is a great advantage to go into the precise meaning of the terms that are more often used in the works of the masters, because they contain a lot of significance. Of course, every one of us, we know something of every word, but to a spiritual student, it's not enough. To the man in the street, it is enough to serve his purpose, but to us, it is not enough, because we want to know and do something which is useful not only to ourselves, but also to the humanity at large. Our purpose is too great that we sometimes glamour to help the planet itself. Now, we'll gather all the concepts that are given here, and also the concepts that are given by the ancient masters. You know the meaning of the mystery place in Greece? The word mystery was used as an equivalent to the word drama when enacted on the stage. Not a drama written and not the script of the drama, but a drama enacted on the stage was called a mystery in ancient Greece. That was the correct meaning of the word. And they had masks used in ancient Greeks and ancient Egypt, they enacted dramas with different masks because it is to conceal their own face and produce the required type of face for the required effect. For example, if there are two people, when one is a criminal, when the other is a law-abiding person, that is, the first is the negative personality and the second is the positive personality, they produced two masks with different faces. One mask to make a show of the psychology of the first fellow and another mask to show the psychology of the second fellow, so that when you see the first mask, automatically you will put almost the same face while looking at it. And while looking at the second face, if the fellow wears the mask and comes to the stage and he says like that, all of us unknowingly we do like that. This they used to do. And there were audience attending the drama, and there were well-trained actors enacting the drama. There was music and opera well-disciplined, and there was the entrance and the exit well-arranged and trained. All these things are used not for entertainment purposes or idle curiosity or to kill the time as we do in the modern dramas. They had a purpose towards which they directed the activity. The purpose was to make your consciousness aware of something. And from that point onwards, to keep up your awareness continuously growing in yourself. And the starting of the change was the effect they aimed at. It was their sole purpose. And only for that purpose, they made the whole show. And the effect was the same both upon the audience and the actors. Not all audience were allowed into those mysteries indiscriminately. But those who wanted to have a starting point to their self-awareness, that is what we call those who wanted to be disciples, and those who have proved their readiness to submit, and they were asked to attend the mysteries again and again until the change started in them, and there were scientific and advanced methods to understand if the change has started or not. Music was used, and the fivefold keyboard of color, sound, smell, taste and touch were used with perfect mastery, with additional application of shape in the form of mask. And when the change has started, then the fellow is said to have received his initiation. It was in that sense that the word initiation was used, because the word never means anything more than a beginning. So there were as many as 33 different mystery plays which were used by the ancient races and nations, and which were once again revived by Pythagoras, and he re-established the mysteries. And the Freemasons tried to re-establish the same thing, but they kept up so much of unnecessary secrecy about the matter that they lost the required keys, and now they are no better than idolaters of their dead symbols. Now in their temples, they have nothing as God except the pride of their secrecy. So, in their original sense, these were the mysteries. In ancient Egypt, India, Mesopotamia, Crete, and the Maya land, those were the places of the original mysteries. And in all those lands, the mysteries enacted were common, and the stories produced were common. And when they were lost totally, we find a distorted records of each mystery school, and it is these records which we call the present world scriptures. That's why we have common stories and incidents in all the world records. For example, the story of the deluge and the Ark of the Noah. You will find this story in all the scriptures of the world. Like that, there are many, many stories that are common. For example, the untimely death of the father and the mother of the 5 children living as widow, and the children being called widow's sons. This is also a story which was common in all the mystery temples of the ancients. It is to prove that the birth of man consciousness is death of God consciousness. The moment man is born, he is separately existing with his own individual consciousness. And hence, God consciousness recedes to the background and disappears. This was figuratively narrated as the death of the father at the time of the birth of the son. Like this, we have many mysteries, the most important of which are 18, recorded about 5,000 years ago in the form of narratives called the 18 Puranas in Sanskrit. So, a time is approaching when the original use of these mysteries is rediscovered, and the halls required, along with all the equipment required, were being called temples. Do you know the meaning of the word temple? What does it mean? Square. The word temple means square. It was the concept of a square within a circle, in the center of which the disciple was asked to stand. And the change that took place in him was called contemplation. Con means the circle, templa means the square. He was expected to realize the process of squaring up the circle. Now we have the word contemplation cut off from this tradition. Then we use it loosely. I say, I am contemplating. So, the halls are called temples. So, the temples are being opened once again. And that is what is called ceremonial magic, or the seventh ray activity. Finally, only one simple point. Otherwise, there are 2 one-ray people here who stop me suddenly. First-ray people. I am submissive because I belong to the second ray only.
Ich bin unterwürfig, weil ich zum zweiten Strahl
gehöre. Here, why masks? Why the makeup of an actor? Only one example I will give you. We call a substance salt. The chemist calls it sodium chloride. And the nuclear science fellow knows its molecules. And he further knows its atoms. Atoms of sodium, atoms of chlorine separately. Goes into the details of each atom, and he finds a great activity going on in the temple of the atom. We are not at all conscious of these activities, but we know only salt because we use it. So all these intelligences of nature that are continuously at work in the atoms, they are concealed and they are having the masks of the properties of matter. We see them only through the masks. And those who are working inside, whom the Tibetan calls devas, they are conducting the whole creation as a drama or a mystery. To make us realize this, and to make us equate the correspondences between the activity of the atom and the activity of the solar system, these mystery plays are enacted. And the masks are also symbolic. And this is the sole purpose of the mystery plays. It is a highly scientific process. No, alone, S-O-L-E. Two first stress, conflicting. So, it is a very highly scientific process. And if we submit ourselves to that process, then only it is possible for us to comprehend the changes that take place. And no amount of third-ray activity or intellectual process is useful at all. This is the main defect of the present university education. It gives the student only the intellectual approach and nothing more. As a result of which, the gateways to intuition are closed. And the student develops into a machine of intelligence and nothing else. I received a warning. Thank you all. Let us try to identify the activity of the seven rays with knowable and identifiable terms. That means the terms in which we can identify, instead of keeping them as abstract truths somewhere in the sky. Such an attempt is necessary. There is a triangular activity going on in this creation, and it includes action, doer, and the done. Without this triangle, there is no existence. If we want to read a book, there should be a reader, a book to read, and the process of reading. If we want to know something, there must be a knower, something to know, and the process of knowing. If we want to think something, there must be a thinker, an object, and the action or the process of thinking. This is the basic triangle that exists as the very basic nature of creation. And in the grammatical language, it is called the triangle of the subject, object, and the predicate, including which the whole creation is a sentence. And from this triangle, let us try to understand the three aspects in terms of the seven rays, which is the only process to understand what the seven rays are. Now I understand. Which of these three is important? Which of these three aspects is the most important of the three? Action. No doubt center is there, also in the form of circumference. But the threefold creation unfolds itself, without which it is only a center and no creation. What we call center is only a oneness of the three that includes all the three. Only when the three are unfolding, the center can manifest. Otherwise, there is no center in its manifestation. For example, anywhere here, there is a center. But only when we locate it, there will be 360 degrees around it. When we do not locate any center, center is dormant. That's why space is defined as the body of God with its center everywhere and circumference nowhere. Since we are in this creation, we should consider about the unfolding aspect. Even before unfolding, the center is described as a threefold center in the ancient sciences. There are three aspects in the center. One is beingness, that is eternal existence. B is being. We can call it shining forth. And the third aspect is becoming. You can call it knowing. Even a point in its very nature is described as threefold by the ancient scientists. In the original Sanskrit books of this science, the first aspect is called Chitta. The second aspect is called Satta. Also, Prakasha, from which Akasha comes. The third aspect is called Jna. In English, generally, we can write it better. It is, write it as J-N-A instead of G-N-A, from which the word Jnana comes. These three unfold into three petals of a flower, and the flower is called the first triad of creation. So, we are here having the three aspects with us. Our mind cannot exist without any one of these three aspects. Can you imagine your mind without any one of these three? If your mind can exist without any one of these three, it exists automatically without all the three put together. There can be either the presence of the three simultaneously or the total absence of the three. No two of these three can exist in your mind. And no one also can exist. It's not possible for one or two of these items to exist in the mind. It is possible for the three to exist or not to exist. When the three are existing, we call it mind.